Hey, and welcome back to a new video. This time we are going to take a look on how to export a layer, an object, a frame from Figma to SVG. So SVG is a vector format that is used a lot across the web especially. And the easiest way to export from Figma, in our example here, this little wizard, is just by selecting the layer itself at first. And as you can see, there's a little bound box around the edges because we will always export in a rectangle shape, let's say, and still have the kind of transparency in this case that we would also have in a PNG image, for example. So we select the layer here and then we go to the export tab on the right and we can simply select SVG. And now I can save it and, for example, save the little wizard to my downloads tab. So saved. Very, very cool. Another option is to save a whole frame. So as you can see here, the wizard also has the bounding box, but maybe I want to export him with a frame around it. And in this case, the frame even has a background color that we can also turn to some red, for example. And I can go here, whoa, real quick, go to the export tab again, and now export as SVG. Save it to the downloads tab. Wizard 2, and that's basically how I can export them. And now I want to show you what happens if I import both of them back into Figma. Yes, we can see here on the one side, we have the wizard, and then we have the wizard in small with the bounding box. So that's the first important thing to know. Another important thing to know is an SVG is basically, if it's a vector, something that you can scale down and scale up as much as you want without being pixelated. And let's make an example for this here. So I have a text here, one letter. And if I just export this letter as a PNG, let's say, we will see something really, really interesting. Because if I move in the PNG again here, you will see it's already pixelated. And even if I scale up and down, it gets more pixelated. Now we are doing the same thing here as an SVG. So let's see if it's the same if we export as a vector graphic. Okay, we've done it. And now we can see if we scale it up and down, it stays very, very sharp, no pixels. And so it's really, really good for us to use it like this, especially if we want to change the size of something. If you have any questions around this, let me know in the comments. Otherwise, you can leave a comment or like a thumbs up, follow for the channel, and see you on the next video. Bye-bye.